guys. Screw a blind wave. I'm Eric.
Shane.
Rick.
I'm Calvin.
Aaron.
And we're here with a trailer reaction to Jay and Silent Bob reboot, which I've seen all of Kevin Smith's movies. I love the Askewaverse. Have you guys seen, at the very least, Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back?
Yes.
No.
No?
No. No.
Okay. So.
I've seen it. Yeah. I think I've seen most of Kevin Smith's. Except for like.
Me and you watch it together.
Walrus and.
Tusk.
Yeah. And Hoosiers or whatever.
Hoosiers.
What?
Yeah,
Hoosiers.
The one in the grocery store.
Yoga Hoosiers.
Yeah.
With his daughter.
Yeah. Yeah.
Not
and Johnny Depp's daughter, too.
Not the Rick Moranis thing.
Yeah. Recently he's come out with a lot of really crazy movies. Tusk was fantastic, but so weird, you know?
Yeah, I've seen like some of his newer stuff. But I've seen like Mallrats, I've seen Dogma, I've seen Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back,
Clerks
and Clerks too.
Since the '90s, since Clerks came out, he's had this kind of running thread that Jay and Silent Bob appear in a lot of them, and in Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back, you know, one of the stories is that in a movie called Chasing Amy, there were two comic book writers that wrote a story that was based off Jay and Silent Bob, the real people. And in Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back, Hollywood had optioned to make a movie with a superhero one. So they had to go there and stop it because people were making fun of them on the internet, saying Jay and Silent Bob are stupid people.
Yeah, weren't they supposed to get money, though?
They were. They did get money, and they used it to fly around the country and beat everybody up was making fun of them.
That's right, yeah. Are you, new Master 69?
Yeah. Wow. Now, Kevin Smith, in the last couple of years, he had a heart attack, and he said the one thing that he really regretted is he never got to do Jay and Silent Bob reboot.
So is this a sequel, or is this...
This is the sequel in which Hollywood is trying to reboot Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back.
Which never got
the movie. And they have to go stop it again.
So they just offer the...
So let's check out this trailer. I'm excited. This just came out. I think Comic-Con's coming around. This is a Red Band trailer. So there'll be some naughty stuff.
I hope there's no monkey.
It's a whimper. A whimper.
All right, you motherfucker.
Oh, shit.
I know you in
there. Heroics.
Come out. Right.
Coming soon.
Cock smoker.
Stop the motherfucking plant!
They opened a dispensary.
No, a chicken sandwich place.
He's got it tucked.
This doesn't have a dick.
He's got a fucking dick. He just got it tucked in.
Identify yourself, like Sons
of the Lambs.
I'm Jay, and this is my head with life mate, Silent Bob.
Don't tell me you guys have no idea there's a new comic book movie being made of the old comic book movie you two are the basis for.
That old ass star-studded piece of shit, that movie sucked balls.
Sucked asshole too.
Oh my gosh.
I object.
I'll allow it. That movie did suck balls and asshole.
We got 3 days to get to Hollywood and stop this reboot from ever happening.
Twice, I had a baby, Jay.
Oh, Shane Elizabeth.
About to meet our love child.
What?
I think I'm gonna need to see a blood test.
No, Jay. This is my daughter, Millennium.
Oh, that's Kevin Smith's daughter.
Can you take us to Hollywood with you?
Fuck no, man. It's a tough-ass neighborhood.
Either you take us to Hollywood, or I stab you both to death on my own front fucking lawn.
And on that note, we cue the music.
Jesus, okay.
Fuck!
I'm glad you guys are smoking back there. I was driving someone about a week ago, and he took a big shit. You have no idea how hard it is to get the smell out of leather.
Your method.
Oh, shit.
Fuck.
Oh. Ben Affleck.
Oh, Iron Man.
Yay. It's Jay. And Silent Bob.
Oh,
there's Chris.
I just found out I have a kid, but I don't know how to be a father.
Anybody with cum can be a father, but only love can make you a dad.
How you gonna talk about love and you flinging cum all over the place? That shit's unseemly, bro.
What do you guys think about this reboot?
Oh, hey!
It sucks. There, I said it. And who's directing this shit anyway? Kevin fucking Smith?
He's Vanderbeek!
Smells like this reboot went up in smoke.
Holy shit, man.
Yeah, man,
hey, nice to meet Kevin Smith.
Jason Mewes.
That's right, we're refugees from the 90s. Get ready for our sequel to Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back, Jay and Silent Bob Reboot. You want to see it? We want to show it to you, so we're bringing it to you, to your hometown.
You can watch it with us, and afterwards, we're going to answer all your questions.
That's right, it's the Jay and Silent Bob Reboot Roadshow. So come on out and join us. Give us your money, because we got to eat this year.
Yeah, and so does my kid, man. So get tickets at RebootRoadshow.com.
They probably got one in Columbus.
Yeah.
Man, there was a lot of people in that.
Dude, there's a lot of,
Seems a lot of fun. Yeah. It's loaded.
Yeah, it does seem like a lot. Those movies are always fun.
Yeah.
But it's always compounded by, like, one, how many times you've seen the movie, or making sure you've seen all the other ones, too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It has a lot of references. A
lot of
references. Like his universe and stuff that he has, you know, because they're all kind of connected amongst each other the way they've
I mean,
done.
His kind of filmmaking style is, I mean, he makes movies so people can enjoy them, but he makes movies that he wants to see, and thus it becomes movies for his fans, you know? So sometimes it can be, like, some in-jokes. You're like, what the hell is going on? But people that listen to the podcast might be like, holy shit, this is amazing, you know?
Yeah. Is that what Kevin Smith's looking like right now?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's lost a lot of weight.
He became a vegan.
Yeah,
he lost
a vegan. He's looking a lot better.
70 pounds?
Yeah. He's looking a lot better.
Heart attack changes a man.
Yeah.
I'm glad he's getting healthy. I don't want the boy to die for a while.
No. Yeah. I was scared when I heard
Give him a little more time.
I wonder how they'll explain in the movie the weight loss.
Yeah, right?
We still wearing the big coat.
He's always calling him like Lunchbox. Come on, Lunchbox, you know? You fat fuck.
And he's just like...
I think he said he had to do a rewrite because of the weight loss.
Yeah, so, I bet.
That's kind of funny. I like the beginning. Is like it's called the... What was it? Cocksmoker?
Cocksmoker, yeah.
Chicken sandwiches.
I like that. They kind of like, drop your plants! So he drops his pants instead.
The quick stop looked like it was all closed up, too. I hope it's that's not
their gas station that they always hung out?
Yeah, the convenience store. It's not even a gas station. It's just the store part of a gas station.
Yeah.
But, I mean, after Clerks 2, I mean, I love Clerks 2, and I love the ending to it.
He's
I hope nothing terrible happened.
Outside rapping there or whatever, right?
Yeah.
Blazing. He has his little song he does.
Yeah.
I like that.
Anyway, that looks great. I mean, Hemsworth was in there.
Oh, yeah. Dude, I love the little, Iron Man suit thing they had.
Yeah.
I couldn't tell who was in it. Was it,
Kevin Smith?
Silent Bob?
I think it was Silent Bob.
Because it kind of, it had, a Robert Downey Jr. look a little bit because it had, the dark hair, mustache stuff, but then it was gone real quick. I'm like,
and,
he's just kicking the shit out of people.
I'd love to do, because in the first movie... James Vanderbeek and Jason
Biggs
played the movie version of Jay and Silent Bob, and now they're rebooting it. They're not getting those guys back. They're pissed off.
And they're talking about how shitty it is.
Did you see, the reboot? Jay is a woman now?
Yeah.
No, so I didn't.
Funny. Yeah,
in the very beginning, Jay.
Like a really hot, chronic, long hair blonde.
Yeah, it's like a woman now. They gendered, but it's so funny. And then the guy that was going up to ask the question to those guys was Brian Quinn from Impractical Jokers.
Mm. I thought I recognized him. He has a lot more beard now.
Yeah. So
that's funny.
Yeah, I love that trailer. I love that. I listened to all the podcasts. I mean, Hollywood Babylon and Smodcast and all that stuff. He does a lot of it.
I like Kevin Smith's movie reviews too.
Yeah.
Because even it's not even it's a little bit more like what we do. Because ours sometimes review stuff, but we kind of just talk about what we saw and how cool it was. And that's pretty much what he does. And he just goes
through
the movie and he's like, dude, here's what happened, and it was this, and I really love this, and he's just going through basically telling you the story of the movie.
Yeah.
And how excited he was at each point. You know.
He's just a fun, positive guy. He never shits on stuff. He does, but when he does it respectfully and stuff that.
Would you like that?
He doesn't.
We need that.
Treat a whole lot of stuff seriously. His daughter was in this, which she's been a Supergirl now a couple of times.
She was in that yoga.
She's actually has a part completely unrelated to, because it was being one of those things where people are like, oh, you cast your daughter and stuff, but she's going to be in that Once Upon a Time in Hollywood movie.
Yeah.
She's legit doing some good work now.
That's good.
Awesome.
But no, yeah, he directed a few episodes of Supergirl and Flash and stuff like that.
Yeah.
He brought in Jason in an episode or two, and then he's brought in his daughter for an episode. And. So it's fun. I like seeing who he brings in. Mm-hmm. And Jason Mewes had this Lamborghini thing that he borrowed from his parents,
He's
trying to appear rich and stuff. And he's like, no, my parents are gonna be mad at me.
Yeah.
That's my mom's car.
Yeah. He had Matt Damon and Ben Affleck in here.
Yeah.
Which I don't think Kevin and Ben Affleck have talked for years.
Really?
Well, it's kind of known that Ben Affleck got really, really famous and kind of stopped hanging out with those guys.
Oh.
I mean, because Kevin bought Ben Affleck's old house, that's the house he lives
in. I thought they talked around the time when he was Batman, because I thought Kevin Smith was talking about...
Well, he talked about trying to get him on his podcast, but he never did. They just, they're not as close, but it's cool that he came back for this.
I like Matt Damon and Ben Affleck, they had big parts in, Dogma.
Dogma is so good, dude.
They're both chasing Amy as well, weren't they?
Well, Ben Affleck was, but it was Ben Affleck and Jason Lee.
Gotcha, okay.
Which Jason Lee's in there as well.
Yeah.
And it's cool to see him and not have his mustache. Because everything I'd seen him in since, he'd always had that My Name Is Earl mustache.
Yeah.
Anyway, looks fun. I'm definitely gonna go see it. And they, you know, he's always done this thing where he actually will take a movie around. You know,
we need to get that in Marietta.
Yeah, that'd be fantastic.
I don't know.
Make our movie happen here.
I don't know what the fan base is. Maybe cool to help hang out and talk to Jason and Kevin about their movie and stuff.
When's it releasing?
I didn't see exactly.
I was about to say September, but that was everything else.
Yeah, that was everything else. Another cool, like, little. I love his editing style because he edits all this stuff too. You know, he writes, directs, and edits. So he'll shoot something, and then that night he'll just edit that scene, and they can come in and watch the scene. You know.
Yeah.
So he'll have the movie done and edited, of course, without visual effects. But like, he'll have it done like 3 days after they've done filming.
Hmm.
So the movie's done. He's probably just gonna be.
Well, because then too, like, if you do that and you have it edited like that day, you have an idea of what you're missing. Like, something's not fitting. I need something else. Rather than trying to, like, well, we got to bring everyone back in and reshoot it. So it's kind of, I guess, in a way cheaper for him to stay up all night editing it so that he knows what he needs while everyone's still there. So.
And it just says coming soon, so we'll have to keep our eye on it. And, you know, Kevin Smith is the first person to tell you, like, I am not a good filmmaker. I just like to make movies.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I don't go into them expecting, like, the best movie ever.
Yeah.
I just always go in to expect having fun. However, Red State, if you guys have seen Red State, that's like up there. That's like a Tarantino-like movie, you know?
I haven't seen Red State.
It's really, really
good. Mentioned it a couple times. Yeah. But
I think it might be on Netflix now, maybe. I don't know. But anyway, that's good, too. I'm talking enough. I like this movie. I will like this movie.
Fat Man on Fat Man.
Fat Man on Fat Man.
You just have a podcast talking about...
No, now it's just Fat Man on regular size.
Former Fat Man.
Guys, thank you so much for watching this reaction. If you want to see more stuff like that, make sure you subscribe to our channel. Go to patreon.com/blindwave if you want to support us. While you're there, check out full length and early access. Go to blindwave.net, check out our story and information about WaveCon coming in August in like 3 weeks.
Smoochie boochies.
Can't say anything in the silent one.